on the Indianapolis?
What happened? Japanese submarine slammed two torpedoes into our side, Chief. He was coming back from the island of Tinian, the lady just delivered the bomb, the Hiroshima bomb. 1,100 men went into the water. The vessel went down in 12 minutes. Didn't see the first shark for about half an hour. Tiger, 13-footer. You know that when you're in the water, Chief? You tell by looking from the dorsal to the tail. Well, we didn't know. Because our bomb mission had been so secret. No distress signal had been sent. They didn't even list us overdue for a week. Very first light, Chief. Sharks come cruising. So we formed ourselves into tight groups. It was kind of like old squares in a battle, like you see in a calendar, like the Battle of Waterloo. And the idea was, shark comes to the nearest man, that man, he starts pounding and hollering and screaming. Sometimes the shark go away. Sometimes he wouldn't go away. Sometimes that shark, he looks right into you, right into your eyes. You know the thing about a shark, he said? Black eye, like a doll's eye. When he comes at you, he doesn't seem to be living until he bites you. And those black eyes roll over white, and then... Oh, then you hear that terrible high-pitched screaming. The ocean turns red, in spite of all the pounding and the hollering, they all come in and they rip you to pieces. By the end of that first dawn, lost 100 men. I don't know how many sharks, maybe 1,000. I don't know how many men, they average 6 an hour. On Thursday morning, Chief, I bumped into a friend of mine, Herbie Robinson from Cleveland. Baseball player, coaches. I thought he was asleep. Reached over to wake him up. Popped up. Ended. Well, he'd been bitten in half below the waist. Noon the fifth day, Mr. Burry, Lockheed Ventura, so she swung him low and he saw his team. The young pilot, a lot younger than Mr. Hooper anyway, he saw us and he come in low. And 3 hours later, a big fat PBY comes down and starts to pick us up. You know, that was the timeline was most frightening.